Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is take some spirit gum, lead mine, whatever you prefer, and you're going to apply this where you're going to want your snows and star wires, which you'll need, looks like this, just like, or you can use mortician's wax, that kind of stuff. You're going to put this in the general area, just in this area. And what you're going to do is take a Q-tip or something, I'm going to use my finger and tap it until it gets nice and tacky. Like so. Make sure you go up as close to the lid as possible because you don't want it to come on. Then you're going to take a modeling tool or something to apply nose and star wax with. I'm using a spatula. I'm going to take my nose and star wax. Looks like that. Just going to scoop out a little bit there. So, and I'm going to wet down my fingertips just so it doesn't get, so it's a little more workable. Because you don't want it to ruin the scar marks. So now you're just going to take your nose and scar wax and kind of create like a sneak look thing. And then you place it kind of like that. And then you just smooth out the edges. Or you can take off the excess that you don't need or want. And then just blend. So, I'm gonna go ahead and finish. So, I'm gonna be right back. And here's kind of a close-up of what I just did. Just a little bit. So, I am gonna be right back.
And you can do as many layers as you would like. I'm only going to do one for the sake of the tutorial. That's what I just did. So I'm going to let this dry. I'm going to finish this. I'm going to finish putting it on, let it dry. And then I will be right back.
Okay, so I finished putting on the latex. Now what I'm going to take is I'm going to take some Ben Nye's neutral set. Baby powder will work for this. What else will work? Cody powder will work. Transition face powder will work as well. Any kind of setting powder will work. And a brush, a powder brush. And you're going to just set it. You want to make sure you got it good because you don't want it to ruin your regular makeup brushes. And then you can pull back some of the scar wax just to make sure that it's not pressed down or anything. So now what you're going to take is you're going to take a makeup brush for one. And then you're going to take, what is this? This is a severe exposure. I'm going to be using this red, and it is, honestly, I don't know what it is, but you can use any kind of red, but that's the red I'm going to be using if you have that wheel. And then I'm just going to take that and coat the inside. It almost looks like a mouth. Like, I don't know, I just think it looks like a mouth. And then when you have that done, you can go ahead and set this with, like, transition face powder or neutral set, whatever you want to use. When you get that done, then you are done with the paint job. It's kind of a close up. So I'm gonna be right back. Okay, now I have finished powdering and I just did a little bit of touch up. So now I'm gonna take my little metal pieces. I'm gonna first take this big nail right here. It has a little bit of a bottom on there. I don't know if you can see that. But this nail is really heavy because the first time I did this look, it was way too heavy. So what I decided to do this time is take just a little bit of ball, just make a little ball of nose and scar wax, and then press the nail into the wax, like so. And then I'm going to take just a little bit of latex. I'm going to use a Q-tip again and just kind of find where I want it. And dab a little latex there. And then take my nail and take the end with the nose and scar wax on it. And then press it into the skin. And then take like a spatula or something and blend out the edges. And then you're just gonna let it dry. And then you can go back and set it again with latex. And then you can paint it over. So here's one closer. So I'm gonna be right back. Okay, so I finished doing that. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take my other little pieces. I'm gonna take this little skewer that I made out of paper clip. Then I just twisted it and I painted it gray. I'm just gonna take this and flatten the bottom of it like that. Just so that way it has a little bit of a, so that we can stand on it. And then I'm gonna find a place that I like it. And then if you just set it in there, kind of push up into the latex, or not latex, I meant no scar wax, it's gonna stay there. So it's kind of weird and cool at the same time. Then you're just gonna take your other little pieces and you can find little places that you like it. And then like these little guys, these are just gonna be glued down with latex. Just get a little latex on the bottom. And then just kind of shove them in there like that. Almost look like little teeth coming out. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish up this look. Here's kind of a close up. So I'm gonna finish it out. Okay, so I am finished the look. I just went in with a little bit of a Q-tip, which is a little Q-tip, and then just a little bit of stage blood from Ben and I, and went in and added some pretty awesome stuff. As you can see, it's pretty awesome. So, thank you so much for watching this tutorial. If you would like to know more about this, just look in the link description below, and I will have the list of products used and stuff like that. And there will be photos at the end, so you can watch those. So please comment, rate, subscribe, or leave tips. That is optional, but always a good thing. Thank you so much for watching. Please go check out my other videos. Either you're watching it either that way or that way, if you're watching it on the computer. So, yeah, whatever. Okay, thank you so much. Until my next tutorial, bye.